Hey everybody, Dutch Sense here. 10:50 a.m. Central Time on Friday, October 23rd, 2015. And I've got you looking at Earthquake 3D, which is a USGS feed of the most recent earthquakes. And I've got many messages from people regarding the swarm of earthquakes developing out in western central Oregon. And there's been nearly, 40, 50 different earthquakes in the past day or two. A lot of activity to see. Nobody talking about what's actually at the earthquake epicenter. And I went over to the Pacific Northwest Seismic Network's website, Professor John Vidali's page, and the other people who are supposedly on top of monitoring the situation on the West Coast, and they don't have any information on what's actually at the earthquake epicenter. Nothing that I could find. Maybe they made some obscure post somewhere, but we'll have to wait and see if they've actually disclosed what's there. Maybe they haven't looked it up. Maybe they don't know what I'm about to show you. So let me just back this out just a little bit to show you the location in question. Here's Oregon, and we're zooming in on the earthquake epicenter, and this is where the swarm is occurring right here. Now, you'll already see something marked right here. This is from the Smithsonian Institute. This is Davis Lake, and this is an old volcano, a volcanic field. And when you look at the area, let me zoom in here a little bit more. These are two lava flows right here. And we'll just zoom in and show you. Okay, and again, this is part of the Davis Lake volcanic field, and you can make out the old cone here. Let's just go around in a 360-degree angle to give you a better view. And there's our lava flow off of that. And that's not the only one. Here's one right next to it. And when I say old lava flow, they're barely covered with trees. So, you know, dating that's going to be pretty hard. But I could tell you this, it's not as old as you'd like to imagine. So here's Davis Lake. Here's another dome right here. These are not fracking operations dug out. I don't know what they've got going on here with all these little pads. There's no apparatus installed on each one of these locations, but there's a mound at each location. So mound, 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 mound. Kind of strange that they've done that where they've piled up mounds of debris at each one of these pads. Don't know what to make of that, guys, but there it is. So, and that goes on and on for miles and miles and miles surrounding the whole area. Maybe it's an old pumping operation. Who knows what the actual cause of those small little pads, what they're doing there. But again, back it out one more time. We've got another lava flow up here to the north. So just north of the lake, here it is. Here's our cones. Okay, now why is the Pacific Northwest Seismic Network and the others in the area not field at the location itself? Let's get an actual line measurement tool to show you how far away this is from the volcanoes itself. 3 miles? 3.4 miles? 4 miles? 4.6 miles? And the furthest dome here, 7 miles. We've got another dome there and another dome there. So when you really look at this, guys, what you really have to see is that this here, this here, this here, these two, also this circular formation, see if we have any others, possibly even Dreadnought Island itself, that those are all volcanoes directly. Weathered down over a long period of time, but no doubt about it. Odell Butte, Hammer Butte, Hamner Butte, and the two other unnamed buttes that aren't showing up on here are definitely volcanic in nature. Now, why don't the professionals look this stuff up? Maybe they do. They don't tell you because they don't want to cause a panic. I'm not saying that there's going to be an eruption, guys. We need to be aware that the earthquakes are developing at the volcanic locations because this plays into the rest of what we've been talking about over the last week now. For the last 4 days, 3 to 4 days, we've seen a dramatic uptick in volcanic activity. I'll put a screenshot on the screen here where the 4.8 struck off the coast of Vancouver Island, British Columbia yesterday. Take a look at it. Directly next to a volcano, undersea, but there it is. And as we go down the west coast, more of the same. Again, multiple locations along the coast of California going down into Mexico, all striking near volcanic locations. Now, what does that all mean? Overall, it means that the pressure that's coming from down below the Pacific plate is translating across vast areas like we saw yesterday with the progression of earthquakes all the way across the South Atlantic going over to the Indian Ocean in just a few hours' time. Less than a day, this whole area across 7,000 miles moved. I did a whole video on it last night. I'll put a link down below to that. Not going to get sidetracked talking about that. All I can tell you guys is that the activity is picking up. And the professionals who you would rely on to tell you about these things, the guys who would, you know, say they know it all and come to my pages to give me a hard time. That's why I'm calling out the Pacific Northwest Seismic Network and Professor John Vidali and his students and the other professors who came over to my pages to give me a hard time from the University of Washington State, along with Professor Vidali, because Vidali ain't telling you the truth about what's going on, or he just doesn't know. And he's the lead director of seismology at the University of Washington, the head director of the Pacific Northwest Seismic Network, is ignorant or plain dumb or deliberately obfuscating the truth on this topic. Now, why? I don't know. Laziness? I don't know. Are they trying to, like, hide something? I don't know. I don't really care what their motivation is for why they're not telling you guys, but for whatever reason, they aren't, or they won't, one of the two. That's why my viewership keeps growing in the Pacific Northwest, even in the face of the big guys giving me a hard time, because they're not doing their job. I'm kind of actually, like, doing their job for them. I'm taking the time to look up the earthquake, take the time to make the video. I get grilled. I'm on the heat if I'm wrong, you know. All these things that should be done by a scientist at a professional institution is being done by me publicly on YouTube instead. And what do? They take the credit for it when it's right. And when they disagree, of course, they don't tell you or they totally rip me apart. They can't disagree with me on this. It's 3 miles from the nearest cone. What are you guys going to say? It's just coincidence that that's where the earthquake's striking? Really? In between Davis Lake and Newberry Crater? Really? I don't want to hear any excuses. This is volcanic in nature. It's not going to erupt, but it's a sign that the greater pressure of the larger earthquake is building in the region. And it always shows that the volcano's first. Longtime viewers already know this. We documented it ad nauseum, but there it is. And let's get one last look at this lava flow and this crater to end the video. Okay, there she blows, guys. If you live out in the area, you might want to go up there. Don't jump in any hot springs. What happened to the guy up at Yellowstone a month ago could happen to you. So don't do that. But just if you're up there, maybe get out there and get a few shots of the area. I don't know, you know, how rural this is. We got a highway right through here, some other roads where it looks like it goes right up to. Just have to wait and see what actually comes out of the area information-wise from citizens, because we're not going to get it from the professionals, guys. Really, you're not going to get it. Be safe.